Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, folks. Michael Zuber, one rental at a time with my real estate expert, Omar. How you doing, sir?
Pretty good. How are you, Michael? What's up, everybody?
I'm doing well, folks. This is just how awesome all my experts are. Internet goes down in the office. He goes, we're going to do it from the phone. I'm like, yeah, yep. That's right. So, hey, Omar, something I'm doing with all my experts this week is we are finding a Dave Ramsey quote, reading it, and then talking about what it means to us. You ready for that?
Yeah, let's go.
So again, I thought of this quote for you because we just reviewed your three deals. We talked about you're probably adding another $1 million in debt, maybe 900 grand. So I'm like, hey, this question or this quote is just for you. Here it goes.
Perfect.
You can't be in debt and win. It doesn't work. What do you think?
You can be in debt and win. You can be in debt and win.
Yeah, I would. It's that. I just can't imagine being where you are or where I am without debt and without millions of dollars in debt. I just can't figure it out.
The thing is, you're not going to be able to scale. And you know what? This is one thing I will share with everyone is that it depends on what you think winning is.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. If you think that winning is you have your house and you pay it off and you have no debt, your vehicles are paid for, everything else is paid for. Okay. That's it.
Awesome.
Cool. Go make your money. And that's all. That's perfect. You made it. But if you want to be able to scale and have more and be able to depreciate more down the road, and this is like another conversation, but I wouldn't be where I'm at. Michael wouldn't be where he's at if we did not carry any debt.
No, I'd still be working. I would still be, that's when I think about this debt, I mean, again, obviously good debt versus bad, all of that, but that's to classify all debt as bad is dangerous and almost disingenuous. Again, I want to be clear, right? We started building our portfolio at 30, financial freedom at 45. I am still working. We probably have 4 houses. I'd be nowhere close. I would have to work till I was 65 instead of 45.
100%.
I consider winning being done at 45. That's my consideration.
Winning done at 45. That's perfect.
That's the
title of your next book.
There you go. Winning at 45. Exactly. Well, hey, I know, you know, your father immigrated to this country. Typically, again, my experience, they have a different mindset about debt. Did you and your father talk about debt at all?
Man, you hit it on the nail. I was going to share with you guys that when my dad and I would always talk, he would always tell me, hey, mijo, pay off everything. Make your money, save it. Don't let it make money for you. Just save it, put it in your bank account or put it underneath your mattress or put it in your safe and then pay off your debt, pay off the house, pay off the car, pay off this, pay off that. I'm like, Dad, because this is one thing I'll tell you. We own a studio. My dad bought a studio or a little salon a long time ago and she carried paper, the previous owner. Well, when the note was due, I came in and I paid it off, right? Mm-hmm. And he's like, well, that's paid off, but, you know, you should pay off, you know, our house too. Ah. And it's like, Dad, it's 3%.
Yeah.
Can I go pay it off? Yeah, here's $100,000, $110,000, cool. But it's like, Dad, like, that's cheap debt. I'll make the payments, no problem. He's like, okay, Mijo, okay. And we've talked about it back and forth for a good while.
Yeah.
But I told him, I'm like, Dad, this is how it worked. Look, if I would have paid it off, if I would have paid anything off, this is what I would have shot myself in the foot twice. And I wouldn't have been able to scale. And he's like, oh, okay. I had to educate him a little bit.
Yeah.
But I love him. I miss him. And it's just, you know, he instilled a lot in me, man.
Yeah. Again, I think this conversation, you know, again, I think you're right. What is winning to you is winning to you working until you're 65, 401k, free and clear house. If that's you, I want to applaud you. I want to say congratulations, all of that. However, if winning to you is earning financial freedom and having assets pay your bills, I have never met anyone who doesn't do that without debt.
Oh, nobody.
It's just can't get done. And again,
where do you think cash flow comes from? Where do you think cash flow comes from? Everybody is paying attention right now.
Yeah.
your loan payment's $1,000 and you're renting out the place for $1,600, that's $600 in positive cash flow that somebody else is paying you for free, right? Mm-hmm. To live at a house that you have encumbered by debt.
Yeah.
At a low interest rate. It's free money right now, people.
Yeah, inflation's at 5, 6, 7, debt's at 3. Again, I think I said this earlier, I'm adding debt to free and clear assets, which would probably drive your dad crazy, but it's the right thing to do today.
It's the right thing to do. Like I have credit lines. I haven't used them, but it's like, all right, cool. I got, you know, $150 on this one, $200K on this one, just in case I need anything real quick, you know?
Oh yeah, I know. Very cool, man. Well, congratulations on your week. Thank you for sharing this quote with me. I appreciate it. How can people follow you?
Guys, follow me on IG at @Omar_Alfaro or reach out 760-559-9945.
Thanks, man. Congrats on the week. Congrats on the 3 deals. Thanks for being a part of this. Take care.
Absolutely. You're welcome. Thanks, guys. Mm-hmm.